What's up, y'all? Welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to talk about how to make a reliable RB engine. The engine that I had in this car was an RB25DET. It was making 440 at the wheels on 93 octane at 23 psi. And I had the motor, just a story about like the motor itself that I used. I had it in the car for 5 years. I probably put about 100,000 miles on it. I ran it at the drag strip. I did burnouts. I basically beat it up a lot. Got into a lot of street races with it. It was a really fun engine. Really loved the sound of an RB. But I'm going to teach you guys on what worked for me when I built my RB. I did a lot of research on it when I did build it. And just some of the stuff that I used on it we're going to talk about. So what I had on it, I had a cosmetic head gasket. I think it was like a 1.3 millimeter. I put that on there. I ran ARP head studs to keep the head down. That way the boost pressure didn't raise the head. I had that all torqued to spec. And then I also ran a better clutch and a flywheel. I ran the competition flywheel. I think it was like a stage 5, 6 puck is what I was running. Because when you start making more power on the RB platform, your clutch is going to start slipping more. And then you're going to need a good ECU. I was running the AEM EMS Series 2. That ECU fit the bill, so I ended up rolling with it. And then you're also going to need a tuner, somebody that knows what they're doing. I had mine tuned by Eric Hargett at CIA Performance in Columbus, Ohio. They tuned mine. Eric's a really, really good tuner, and he's tuned RBs throughout like his lifetime as a tuner. He's tuned a lot of high-end cars, a lot of other stuff, but a tune is going to be super important for your build. It's basically like the heart and the brain of the whole entire build. And then you're going to need bigger fuel injectors, because you don't want any fuel starvation, and the more fuel, the more power you're going to make. You're going to need a bigger fuel line for your RB25. And then you're going to need also a bigger pump. I was running a Bosch 044. And then also you're going to need a intercooler, because you got to cool the air coming into the motor. So I ran a Vibrant 4-core intercooler bar and plate. It worked really well for me. And then different types of fuels that you could use. 93 octane you could use. You could use E85. They're all going to make more horsepower. Than like 87 or 91, 92, whatever. So you want to run a good quality fuel that you can always have abundance to, like rolling up to a gas station. Whatever is good in your area is what I would get. That way you ain't got to like store it or something, because that would really suck. And then an issue with like the RBs is everybody knows the head drains or the drainage issues with it. So I ran a spool head drain on it, and I had it teed off to my oil drain, and that worked perfectly fine for what I was doing with it. Some people run the restrictors in them. If you're doing like drifting or something, I would definitely do that. And then the oil pump that I was running was an M1 oil pump with the stock gears, but that pump worked perfectly fine for me. I wasn't planning on drifting it or anything, and they didn't have the billet gears back then as they do now. So if you do an RB, if you do decide to build an RB, I would definitely buy some billet gears to throw in it just for a peace of mind. And then you're going to want to buy a quality timing belt. I used a Tome timing belt. I used OEM idler and tensioner pulleys. Replace those. You might as well when you got the motor apart. And then I used the OEM water pump, because I wasn't planning on revving it out super high. And another thing you might want to get is a catch can. That way you don't recirculate that nasty oil back into your motor. You could use a vented one. If you want to use a recirculated one, that's completely up to you. I would definitely use a vented one, but that's just me. And then another thing, I got a list of things here, because there's a lot of stuff to an RB to make it reliable. It's just not the motor itself, it's the stuff around it that you also got to get. That's why I'm talking about those parts also, because everybody always talks about the motor. They don't talk about anything else around the motor that's required to make the engine reliable. They just forget about that. They just think it's strictly the motor that has the issues. Another thing that you can get is a good quality turbo manifold. I ran a log style manifold on a Garrett GTX 30. I think it was a 76R with a 82 millimeter turbo or 82 housing. Sorry, is what I was running on the backside of it. I think that AR housing is kind of geared more towards like drifting. If I would go back and do it again, I would definitely run a bigger housing on it just to have some better spool. And then another thing that you're going to need is a good quality turbo manifold. I went with the log manifold because it was available at the time as a kit from a raw brokerage. Is where I get a lot of my parts. I was like, hey, I'll just buy that kit. So anyways, I would definitely get a good quality manifold, maybe like a 6 boost, something like that. There's a lot of different manifolds on the market. I think they make a manifold also. I ended up on my next build, I actually got the motor pulled right now. I got it at the machine shop right now. I'm building it for 800 horsepower. I plan on building a street outlaw car for drag racing. That way I can drive it on the street. In the street outlaw class, you got to drive it around on a road, and then you got to go in and run it at the drag strip. So it's got to be completely compliant with everything. There's a lot of regulations and all that other stuff. But I plan on daily driving this car and competition drag racing it. So I got the motor pulled right now at the machine shop, and I'm going to... I already bought all the parts to build it and everything. The only thing I need right now is some like turbo lines and drain oil lines, and then I need to buy the turbo, and then I got to do a lot of suspension work on the car, but I'll make content on that also. And then another thing that you're going to need for the to make a reliable RB is a fuel pressure regulator also. I almost forgot to mention that. You're going to need a fuel pressure regulator. That way you can tune the fuel pressure to get the right air fuel ratio that you're needing, and that's going to be all about tuning. And then you're also going to need a wide band and then a oil pressure gauge. That way you can monitor your oil. You can even have like a safety switch on it to start blinking if you wanted it to. I had an oil pressure gauge on mine with a warning light to let me know if it was losing oil pressure when I was high up in RPMs or on the limiter. But the reason my RB25 failed wasn't because of the normal reasons that all the other RBs failed. Mine actually lost compression on cylinder 5. And it lost compression on cylinder 5 because I was revving the motor 1,000 over the RPM. I believe the rev limiter, I think mine was set at 7,800. So it was 1,000 over. I can't remember what the stock rev limiter is for the RB. But mine was set at 7,800. So I ran it like that for a long time, and there were a lot of times where I did hit the limiter, and eventually it just wore down on the spring pressure for the exhaust valve, and then the valve wasn't closing anymore. So I was basically living on borrowed time with that head, because I knew I was going to eventually pull it and rebuild it. That's the only reason I set it up 1,000 over, and I wanted that extra 1,000 RPMs. That way I can create more power on the top end, which this thing produced a lot of power mid to top end. Like, it was enormous. It was really good on like highway racing because I was more in the top end of the RPM band. Down low it was really sluggish, but the block was completely stock. The camshafts, the rods, the pistons, the crank, the bearings, everything was stock. I just did a few upgrades on the motor itself. And then I did a lot of upgrades on the chassis itself to make the RB super reliable. Please like and subscribe, and I'll be making future videos on the RB motor and this chassis.